Lambert a gate, Lambert Airport. That's an interesting one. Gas must be off. Yep. Try that again. Flaps are up. Flaps are up. Get some light on the subject here. Turn on the alternator. next. Navigational lights. Taxi. RPMs up about 7. Brakes off. RPMs up about 17. 100. Test magnetos. We're going to turn the key. And we should see the RPMs drop down a little bit. You can see the key down on the lower left. I have it on my dash. I turn it to just the left. Drop down. Put it back on both. Turn it to the right. Only. That tells us both magnetos are working. Check the electronics, the battery. I turn the battery off. You watch the amp gauges on the left there. Check the alternator. See the flaps, they're up. Compass is the main, this magnetic compass. This one can drift, so you always want to make sure that this one matches that one. And right now it is. It's like a mirror image. This is off to the right, this one's off to the left, that's normal. Alright, there's a trim wheel. Trim the elevator. Get the plane to fly straight, level. Fly level. Back off our throttle. Down on the floor is our fuel tank selection. On both right now, left tank, right tank. This doesn't have a for the pitch. Pitch on this plane isn't variable. These are different, so RPMs. This is our vertical speed, our rate of climb and rate of descent. This is our altimeter. You always look at the small hand first. It's how many thousand. And little hand, and the big hand is the hundreds. So in St. Louis, we're under 1,000 feet. We're about 575 feet elevation. This is our turn indicator, our bank. And the ball, it's almost like in a level. It will get outside the liner and use your rudder to get the ball back in the center. Instructor may tell you to step on the ball, that's what they mean. It's our airspeed. This plane, when it get up to about 65 knots to take off, 10 degree flaps. Now when you're landing with full flaps, you can get down to an airspeed of like 40 before the plane is stalled. It's our fuel tanks. And right, we have a half a tank. This is the temperature of the exhaust and our fuel flow, and then our water temperature and oil pressure. Well, it's actually oil temperature and oil pressure. A vacuum amperage. This is to keep track of doing maneuvering and stuff. Like if you're doing over speeds or something, it can tell the mechanic if you stress the plane, it needs extra attention. This is our OBS. It has to do with our navigation. You can navigate by different types. VOR is a very high omnidirectional radio frequency. Depending on how high you are, depending on how well it picks up. Our horizon gauge. This also shows us our rate of climb or descent. This is our compass. And we have this is a holder style directional. For a bearing, set of bearings. It's called ADF, Automatic Direction Finder. These are two separate Garmin radios. This is a Garmin 530, GNS 530, GNS 430. Up here's where you can set your navigation for your VOR. What you do is put in a VOR transmitter tower that's, they have different ranges depending on height. About the shortest distance, it's 40 nautical miles that you have to be within to pick it up. You dial that in on your navigational frequencies. And you have two comm frequencies, two navigational. So you can actually swap them, have a backup in, and these only go within certain rates, ranges. Once the arrow is lined up and it's locked on to the VOR, move this and it will move this back and forth. Get it in the center, and then wherever it's pointing towards, that's where you want to fly towards. In that direction to stay on course. This is for your. I haven't messed much with it, but the DME, and then you have your ADF gauge for automatic direction finding. These have different screens. CDI, that changes your GPS, the VLO. And this is for your VORs, the OBS, message flight plan, VNAV is vertical navigation. You can set it at different altitudes to be at different points in your flight. This is a procedure that you can set your procedures up for your flight plan. We have a flight plan in right now. You can see the GPS radar there. This is our flight plan. One from KSTL, which is the ICAO of the airport. It's in Belleville. Be landing on ILS and ILS approach 32R runway. And you have to move different waypoints along the way. If you want to get back to kind of ground ground zero, you know, clear and go back there. You can rotate your different variations of the screen and map. Same way with down here. This is for our autopilot. Well, I fly by heading. I set the heading bug. This is your heading bug. So you can put that right there. If I engaged the autopilot heading, it would fly on that course, that direction. And then you can control your altitude far as to keep it level at a certain foot. This is your transponder that you turn on for the tower to be able to keep track. It's off right now. Turn it on too. And they'll tell you what squawk code you want. That's what you key in there. That's how they keep track. When you're communicating with the tower, you first let them know the entire identification. So like I'd be Cessna Alpha Sierra, X-ray Golf Sierra. Tell them where you're at, what you want to do. They have a ground. They have the ATC air traffic controllers for ground. And they have them for probes. They have them for the tower. And then they have them for flight following. And they keep track of you, warn you of planes in the areas to keep a lookout for them and say you see them. Cessna Alpha Sierra, X-ray Golf Sierra. Let's test the lights. This is just circuit breakers in case something throws. Hopefully you're able to move the circuit breaker and have it reset. Going to be flying to Belleville. So we can look at our I showed you our flight plan. It's actually up on there. Zoom this in and out. Sit here at the gate. Okay, so I'm going to contact the tower. Ground and ask them to get us to push away. a recorded message of the airport. Gives you UTC time visibility. Runways that are active gives you the barometric pressure that you set for your altimeter as it would change. The elevation reading depending on the barometric pressure. Usually it's 29.92. Listen to it here. ATIS is a
St. Louis Airport information, Charlie 1200 Zulu. Wind 271 at 7. Visibility 7. Sky condition, few clouds at 500 feet. Temperature 14. Dew point 13. Altimeter 29.92. ILS runway 29er, ILS runway 30 right and ILS runway 30 left in use. Landing and departing runway 29er, runway 30 right and runway 30 left. DSR aircraft, say direction of flight. All aircraft read back hold short instructions. Advise controller, on initial contact, you have Charlie.
What's the name of the air traffic?
St. Louis Airport information Delta 1200 Zulu.
Their handle is Charlie. There's the altimeter, 29.9er. ILS runways. It's an instrument landing. It is in 30 left. VFR is visual flight. So if you're only licensed for visual flight, they want to know which way you need to go to depart. Then they'll taxi you to that runway. If you're instrument trained, you can fly the IFR instruments and UCs. Alright, we call ground services to get our pushback. This would be if we wanted the jetway to connect back to this. Don't need that. Find the pushback.
St. Louis clearance delivery Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra IFR to Mid-America, ready to copy.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra is cleared to Mid-America Airport as filed. Take off runway 30 left climb and maintain 3,000 feet. Departure frequency is 126.5 squawk 0534.
That's the, what we need our transponder on. Gotta acknowledge back.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra cleared to Mid-America Airport as filed.
This is a change.
Take off runway 30 left climb and maintain 3,000 feet.
We'd have to
departure on 126.5 squawk 0534.
Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra, read back is correct. Contact ground on 118.925 when ready to taxi. Good day.
118.19. Let's see if we can get ground service shut. Request pushback. Okay. Just have them push us straight back.
St. Louis ground, Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra requesting pushback.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra, pushback request accepted.
We can put the, take the brake off down there. I can do it from here too. There, it's off. They're gonna push us back. To tell them when enough's enough. Could have them push us to the right so we would go back this way.
St. Louis ground, Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra requesting the end of pushback.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra request to end pushback received. Airbus 61 Bravo, hold position caution, other traffic.
They're talking to other planes.
Hold position, Airbus 61 Bravo.
Take off runway 30L. Okay, we need to get taxi cards. Taxiing IFR.
St. Louis ground, Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra with Delta ready to taxi IFR.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra taxi to end hold short of runway 30 left using taxiway Charlie Delta 1 Delta Charlie Golf. Contact tower on 118.5 when ready.
He's taxiing now on these taxiways to 30L. And when we're ready, we go to 118.5.
Taxiing hold short runway 30 left via taxiway Charlie Delta 1 Delta Charlie Golf Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra.
So follow it, but I've got the grip turned on. Follow us. Steer with the rudder pedals on the ground. Rudder pedals have left and right toe brake. Work independent of each other. East. Now we're going to be taking off to the west, 30L. Runs east and west. They said the wind direction is 271. It's 7, I believe. So we're pretty much going to take off into the wind, which is good. Have a headwind to have give us lift, and it's blowing at 270 degrees, which is west, coming from the west. Windsock doesn't look too windy there. But close to the end of the runway, 30L. Got to hold it short of the runway and then contact them on 118.5. Let them know we're here at 30L holding. I'm ready for takeoff.
St. Louis Tower, Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra, ready for departure, runway 30 left IFR to Mid-America.
Cessna Alpha Sierra, X-ray Golf Sierra altimeter, 29.9, 2 and 271 at 7. Cleared for takeoff, runway 30 left.
Okay. Go out there and line up. Look, make sure there's no, so now I gotta acknowledge her to yell at me.
Cleared for takeoff, runway 30 left, Cessna Alpha Sierra, X-ray Golf Sierra.
I'll have you do a run up. Sometimes they have run up places. I can do it here. Hold the tow brakes on. But I don't want to block the runway too long here because some may be coming in here landing. Alright, you gotta put the flaps down. 10 degrees. I have a switch on my controller down 10 degrees. Now we're gonna, I already verified that the trim wheel was set to neutral for takeoff. Always kicks to the right as you give it speed, so you gotta give it right rudder. And watch our airspeed. Get up there a little over 60 and we pretty much rotate. I don't have a gear that I need to retract. I got the flaps down. You should fly down the runway. I'm going to put the flaps up. And I want to just see the runway there. I can. Nose down a little bit, you can see the altimeter.
Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra contact St. Louis departure on 126.5.
Good day. So we're going west.
Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra, did you copy?
What'd they say?
St. Louis Tower, Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra, say again, please.
Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra contact St. Louis departure on 126.5. Good day.
Going to 126.5 Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra.
Change the radio. There, 126. That's what I would change it up, you know, up here. little hands on too, so we're 2,300 feet. We're climbing pretty good. I'm gonna let up on the power a little bit. They actually said they wanted us up to 3,000, so I can still do that. I have to pick up on our flight plan, our automatic pilot. There's a line here. Trim wheel down, get us to fly a little more levels, level us out around 3,000 feet. Step on the left rudder, all in the middle a little bit there. We're heading south right now, but we're going to head towards the east. Okay, I'm going to back off on power a little bit. And I'm going to turn on the automatic pilot. Navigation. GPS. And a vertical speed. So it's actually turning by itself right now. And we gotta get our altitude. And we're at 2,400. Go ahead and get down. Now we gotta change the 3,400 down. Now we can set the vertical speed to go down, say 100 feet per minute. So we'll start descending 100 feet per minute to get to 3,000. That's the middle marker. You have an outer marker, which is about 7 to 10 miles out. Middle marker is about 3 or 4, and the inner marker is right there at the runway. Check our RPMs. We're well below the range. Red. It's on vertical speed, the rate of descent, which we have set at 100. Once it gets to 3,000, it'll quit going down.
departure Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra is passing 3,200 feet, descending 3,000 feet.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra St. Louis departure altimeter 29.92 continue as planned.
Simulator, they allow you to pull this out to see it better. We're flying along the imaginary line there. Sun's rising, so get it up over us. Clock, so it's up over the top. See a little better. Airport over there. See our speed level out at 3,000. VS went off and stayed on altitude to hold it at 3,000 feet.
Cessna 02 Tango traffic is 3 o'clock 3 miles at 6,300 feet Cessna Skyhawk. Report them in sight.
They're telling us there's a light over there at 3 o'clock. 6,300.
St. Louis approach Cessna November 6820, hotel 6,200 feet. Lambert Decimal Niner 2, continue as planned.
Set
the 02 Tango, have the traffic.
They said they have it, but I don't. Thank you. 32R. That means runway is 320 degrees, which is down here. Right here, exact. So that means we'll be landing on
Decimal 15 for Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra.
run into each other. They have different stars. Yeah, stars and SIDS. SIDS are for departures. Stars are for arrivals.
Five o'clock.
getting closer.
Kansas City Center, Cessna Alpha, Sierra, X-ray Golf, Sierra, 3,000 feet.
Cessna 134, contact Kansas City Center on 128.1. Good day. Cessna Alpha, Sierra, X-ray Golf, Sierra, Kansas City Center, altimeter 29.92, continue to echo November Lima as planned. Cessna 06, Quebec, please expedite your climb 6,200 feet. Cessna 11 Kilo, contact Kansas City Center on 124.3. Good day. Landmark 4409er, please expedite your climb flight level 280. Cessna 629er, please expedite your climb 8,200 feet. Cessna 423, please expedite your climb 5,000 feet.
Starting to follow our,
Cessna 373 traffic is 9 o'clock, 2 miles at 2,100 feet, Cessna Skyhawk. Report them in sight. Generic 220, please expedite your climb flight level 210. Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra descend and maintain 2,400 feet.
Alright, once we drop down to 2,000.
124.3 for Cessna, 11 kilo.
Cessna 14 Mike traffic is 10 o'clock, 1 mile at 800 feet, Cessna Skyhawk. Report them in sight. Landmark 4409er, please expedite your climb flight level 280. Cessna 423, please expedite your climb 5,000 feet.
Descend and maintain 2,400 feet, Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra.
Cessna 14 Mike traffic, in sight.
Kansas City Center, generic November 547, 4 Bravo 900 feet. Generic 220, please expedite your climb flight level 210. Generic November 5474 Bravo Kansas City Center Altimeter 2.92 continue as planned. Cessna 06 Quebec, please expedite your climb 6,200 feet. Landmark 4409er, please expedite your climb flight level 280. Cessna 423, please expedite your climb 5,000 feet.
They wanted me to,
Kansas City Center, generic November 89er 400, 8,200 feet. Generic November 89er 400, Kansas City Center, altimeter 2.92 continue as planned. Generic 220, please expedite your climb flight level 210. Cessna 06 Quebec, please expedite your climb 6,200 feet. Landmark 4409er, please expedite your climb flight level 280. Cessna 629er, please expedite your climb 8,200 feet. Cessna 423, please expedite your climb 5,000 feet. Cessna Alpha Bravo November traffic is 1 o'clock 3 miles at 4,800 feet, Cessna Skyhawk. Report them in sight. Generic 400, please expedite your climb 8,200 feet. Generic 220, please expedite your climb flight level 210. Cessna 526 traffic is 3 o'clock 3 miles at 2,400 feet, generic. Report them in sight. Cessna 06 Quebec, please expedite your climb 6,200 feet.
Going down,
Kansas City Center, landmark 5369er 600 feet. Landmark 4409er, please expedite your climb flight level 280. Landmark 5369er, Kansas City Center, altimeter 2.92 continue as planned. Cessna 423, please expedite your climb 5,000 feet. Generic 220, please expedite your climb flight level 210. 125.3 for Cessna 69 Alpha. Cessna 06 Quebec, please expedite your climb 6,200 feet. Landmark 4409er, please expedite your climb flight level 280. Cessna 629er, please expedite your climb 8,200 feet. Cessna 423, please expedite your climb 5,000 feet.
Kansas City Center, Cessna November 2089er, call 5,100 feet.
Cessna November 2089er, 4 Kansas City Center, altimeter 2.92 continue as planned. Generic 400, please expedite your climb 8,200 feet. Generic 220, please expedite your climb flight level 210. Cessna 06 Quebec, please expedite your climb 6,200 feet. Cessna 72 Bravo, please expedite your climb 9,200 feet. Landmark 4409er, please expedite your climb flight level 280. Cessna 629er, please expedite your climb 8,200 feet. Cessna 423, please expedite your climb 5,000 feet. Landmark 2727, please expedite your climb flight level 320. Cessna 894, please expedite your climb 5,000 feet. Generic 400, please expedite your climb 8,200 feet. Generic 220, please expedite your climb flight level 210. Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra traffic is 10 o'clock 3 miles at 900 feet day or TBM 9. Report them in sight. Cessna 06 Quebec, please expedite your climb 6,200 feet. Landmark 5369er traffic is 1 o'clock 2 miles at 2,400 feet Cessna Skylock. Report them in sight. Landmark 4409er, please expedite your climb flight level 280. Cessna 629er, please expedite your climb 8,200 feet. Cessna 423, please expedite your climb 5,000 feet. Cessna 55 Foxtrot, contact St. Louis approach on 125.2. Good day. Generic 220, please expedite your climb flight level 210. Kansas City Center Airbus Charlie, Golf Charlie Whiskey Juliet flight level 210. Airbus Charlie, Golf Charlie Whiskey Juliet Kansas City Center, continue as planned.
Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra.
Landmark 5369er have the Cessna Skyhawk in sight. Airbus Charlie Whiskey Juliet, please expedite your climb flight level 210.
10 miles. Raises up to 2,000.
St. Louis approach Cessna November Niner, flight 14 Mike 900 feet.
Cessna November Niner, flight 14 Mike St. Louis approach altimeter 29.92 continue as planned.
St. Louis approach landmark 1340 is passing 6,200 feet, descending 2,400 feet.
Landmark 1340 St. Louis approach altimeter 29.92 continue to ECNOC as planned. St. Louis approach generic November 3450 Papa 800 feet. Generic November 3450 Papa St. Louis approach altimeter 29.92 continue as planned.
Thank you.
traffic. St. Louis approach Cessna November 4968 November 4200 feet. Landmark 1340, you are 13 miles southeast of Mid-America. Contact Mid-America Tower on 128.25 when inbound on the approach. Cessna November 4968 November St. Louis approach altimeter 29.92 continue as planned. Tower on 128.25 landmark 1340.
St. Louis approach Cessna November 1176 Bravo 6900 feet.
Cessna November 1176 Bravo St. Louis approach altimeter 29.92 continue as planned. November traffic is 11 o'clock 4 miles at 6,100 feet Cessna Skyhawk. Report them in sight. Cessna 76 Bravo traffic is 9 o'clock 4 miles at 3,000 feet Cessna Skyhawk. Report them in sight. Cessna 68 November traffic in sight. Contact St. Louis approach on 124.2. Good day.
Going to 124.2, Cessna 14 Mike.
November contact St. Louis approach on 124.2. Good day.
Mid-America ground, Cessna Alpha Sierra X-Ray Golf Sierra, request taxi to the gate.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-Ray Golf Sierra, taxi to gate 12 using taxiway Charlie.
Taxiing to gate 12 using taxiway Charlie, Cessna X-Ray Golf Sierra,